It's Christmas Day and I'm off to a rent house because there is a water pipe that bursts. So stay tuned on what to do when we have wintry blasts that come to Texas once or twice a year. Welcome to Texas weather, my friends. This is Mike Yo.
This is Mandisa, wishing you a very merry.
So this house has a water line that goes above the garage to the outside faucet. Not sure why it was plumbed that way, but well, it is what it is. And unfortunately, above the garage, they are not insulated. Insulation only is needed for the outside wall of the house, of a living space. So garage is not considered a living space. So they do not insulate above the garage attic or the wall of the garage. They will insulate the wall between the garage and the house because technically the house is a internal livable space. So with this house, with the copper line running above the garage, there is no insulation other than just a foam around the copper pipe, which is not enough. And that is why water got frozen, broke the connection, and when it's starting to thaw, that's what happens. So here are a couple of things you need to know about your house. One is, during the winter time, make sure you know where your shutoff valve is, or if you don't have a shutoff valve that you can't find, make sure you know where the city meter is. You also want one of these tools. These are called water meter key, and this is handy to have. Make sure you store them where you know where it is, and I usually hang it up in the garage wall so I know where it is, so you can get to the meter and shut off the meter if you have an emergency, especially with a water leak. Make sure that you open up the cabinet doors underneath the sink so that you can let some air flow to it so that it's not as cold as it's being shut off, and especially those that are on the exterior wall, and make sure to drip your faucet as well. And last but not least, make sure you have good homeowner's policy, or if you're a renter, make sure you have a good renter's policy that would cover any kind of damage. I know it's unfortunate, sometimes there's nothing we can do. In this case, there's nothing we can do about this house because of the way that they have plumbed the house. But just make sure you have homeowner's policy that would cover damages, or if you're renting, make sure you have a good renter's policy. This is Mike Yo. Merry Christmas. Unfortunately, hey, at least they still have power and they were still able to stay overnight in the house until we get the pipe capped off this morning and turn water back on. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Want more content like this? Don't forget to subscribe, comment, or like if you want to watch more videos like this. I'm Lorena.
I am Mike Yo.
And we are 316 Team Realty.
Thanks for watching.